Hello, my dear students. So now we are syllabus is over for the first semester exam. Now we are going to see the modern question paper. And here modern question paper pattern with examples solved. For that we are going to see in this session about the modern question paper. Now you are going for first semester exam. You are going to write for the 80 marks. 80 marks question paper is there. And so how it is distribution is there for our modern. Here for the question paper, how many marks questions are there, like objective type, one sentence answers questions. About that we are going to see here in this session. So here, as you know, there is a total 80 marks question paper is there, and in that 80 marks question paper you are going to write that 1 to 3 hours, and you have to distribute it properly. Where are the diagrams are there, problems are there, we are going to solve on that. So these are the different types of questions, or 1 mark questions, 2 marks questions, 3 marks, 4 marks and 5 marks questions are there. So big questions are there, maybe that one distributed in a smaller questions, and also there are the problems are there on the lesson, like the electricity is there, otherwise the magnetic effect of electric current is there. So by that you have to solve the problems answer from that lesson. So now here in this time, here in this session we are going to see the modern question paper pattern with examples solved. So here first of all question number 1. Here question number 1, objective type of questions we are first already is there, and in that objective type of question 8 questions of 1 mark each. There are how many questions are there? 8 questions, objective type of questions, 8 asking the, and it is for 1 mark each. So total marks are there for that question number 1, that is the 8 marks are there. That are the objective type of questions. So here I have 2 examples for that. Only 2 examples are there. I am going to show here. This is only pattern of the question paper. These questions are not only going to ask for your exam. There is a different questions are there. Only it is a pattern. Which type of pattern is there? That I am going to show you here. So here, example 1 for the objective type of question. Dash of the following chart does not contain water for crystallization. So here are the 4 objectives here, and one you have to choose. Which one is the correct answer you should choose and write that. Dash of the following salt does not contain water of crystallization. Baking soda, gypsum, mercury and sodium hydroxide. So water of crystallization. Crystals of waters are there, they are going to form out here. And you know that there is the metals and non-metals relation is there. In that, here already you learned about the here in the acid and base lessons about the water of crystallization. Water of crystallization is here. Number of water molecules are there. Which number of water molecules present in the formula of a unit of a salt? There is a minimum type of a salt is there, and in that salt there is a number of which number of water molecules are present in that salt. That is called as the water of a crystallization. So as you know, there is the acid basis lessons. You learn about the crystallization of water or crystals of the salts. How they are about that learned. In that, about the copper sulfate when experiment is there, and also about the plaster of Paris. There is a formation of a gypsum. And so, gypsum is there. It is one of the water of the crystallization. One of the salt for this water of crystallization is the gypsum is there. In that, its number of water molecules are present. So, here the answer is there. Dash of the following salt does not contain water of crystallization. That is the answer is there. That is the gypsum is the answer here. So, first answer objective, that is the gypsum. Second one, 3 resistors of 20 ohm, 4 ohm, 8 ohm are connected in a series. And now here, in a series, there is a total resistance in the circuit they asked. Total resistance we have to calculate in the circuit, how much it is there for that. So, total resistance, as you know, that students are, registers are there and it will not that. So here there is the formula is there, R1 plus R2 plus R3, because the three registers are there. By that you have to change the value and you can calculate the total resistance in the series. How much it is there? So 20 plus 4 plus 8. The answer you are going to get, that is the 20 plus 4, 24, 24 plus 8, 32 is the answer. So answer is the total resistance in the series circuit is there, that is the 32 ohms. So answer you should write there, 32 ohms. So these are the objectives, like this type of objectives are there that you are going to ask here for your exam. So this is the question number first, when objective type of questions, 8 questions are there going to ask us here. How many are there? 8 questions of 1 marks each. So total marks are there for the question number 1, that is the 8 marks are there for the here question number 1. So here second question is there, second question here, answer the following questions here, and it is in a answer the following question in one sentence each out, one word you are going to write the answer which have maybe 1 mark or 1 mark questions are there, and here for each question 1 mark totally there is the 8 questions are there, and so 8 marks are there for each question. 8 questions of 1 mark each asking. Maybe answer is in a 1 mark or in 1 sentence it is there. So here answer the following questions. 8 questions of 1 mark each. 8 into 1, that is the 8 mark question is there, second question. In that, see here, I gave the 2 examples for that. So example 1 for the question, that is which metal do not corrode easily. Which metals are there? They are not corroding easily. So in the metals, non-metal essence, reactivity series, it is very much necessary. Reactivity series from higher reactivity to the low reactivity, middle reactivity series, the element metals are there, about that you should study properly. So there is the metals. Which metals do not corrode easily? Which type of metals are there not corroding easily? Not asked only examples here, they asked which type of metals, why they are not corroding easily. Metals which are less reactive, they are less reactive one. Means like iron is more reactive. Yes, so like that, there are the different metals are there. Zinc is there, iron is there, otherwise there are different other metals, aluminium is there. So these different metals, gold, silver, gold, like these different metals are there. These metals, in that, which metals are there, they do not corrode easily. About that we are going to see. See here, metals which are less reactive. You know that copper, iron, aluminium, they are more reactive. So, but which are not corroding easily, which are less reactive, and at the bottom reactivity series. So reactivity series is there in the metal non-metal essence. See that one properly. And here learn that one properly, which are about the chart of that, which are the high reactivity series, metal reactivity series, and also there is a low reactivity series. Which lie, and so here metals which are less reactive and lie at the bottom of a reactivity series, that is silver, gold, platinum are there. They are the lying at the bottom of the series. They are less reactive. You know, we are getting the gold and silver here different jointly. That is because of they are less reactive. Reactive is there, and they are lying at the bottom of the reactivity series. They do not react with the atmospheric gases. So here, because of that, they are not corroding easily. So this is the answer. It is expecting about the which metals do not corrode easily. So this is the first question for the 1 mark, that is the one sentence. Next question is the second question. Which are the main components of the neutron? Which are the main components? As you know, in the last process lesson, you learned about the circulatory system, blood circulation is there, transportation in a human being, about that. And also about the life process lesson is there, in the digestive system is there, it is not there, respiratory system is there, not there for your syllabus. About the plants are there, it is also not there, transportation. And so here, next one is transportation in plants, it is there. But how there is a effect of photosynthesis, formation of the plant, food in the plant. So about that, it is not there for your syllabus. So here, only the transportation in human being and excretory system in the human being. So, and about the transportation in the plants, about silent poem is there in your syllabus. So here, about the asked the question in the live process. Already you know there is a chemical reaction lesson, first lesson is just script related. Also, there are some points are there in the acid basis, metal, non-metal lessons. In that also some points are skipped in the life process lesson. As I told, digestive respiratory systems are there, they are also skipped. So here there is a transportation in human being and also about the excretory system is there. It is there that points are there for the syllabus. And also about the some points are there about transportation, it is there for your syllabus. So excretory system. Here excretory system is that you know. Nephrons are there present in the kidney. 1.5 million of the nephrons are present in the kidney. They are the located or basic filtration units are there. That are called the basic filtrating units in the kidney. They are called as the nephrons. And here question asked, see which are the main components of the nephron. Which are the components are there? They are present in the nephron. Glomerulus, bombus capsule and green and tubule are the main components of the nephron. So in the nephron, there is the main components are there. They are the glomerulus. So as you know, the diagrammatic representation observe that one, and also the structure and the function of the nephron, it is very much necessary. Learn it properly, diagram, practice, hard diagram, otherwise also the nephron diagram is there and excretory system diagrams are there, you should practice that all diagrams properly. So here ask the main components of the nephron. So cup-like structure is there, that is the glomerulus, and Bowman's capsule is there, cup-like structure inside that blood capillaries here which are present, that are nothing but the glomerulus. So here there is a cup-shaped structure, that is the Bowman's capsule, inside that renal artery, renal veins are there, that forms or there is a filtration of blood where taking place, that is called as glomerulus. So glomerulus, Bowman's capsule, and long tubule-like structures are there, long tubule-like structures are there, that is called as the renal tubule is there present. These are the main components are there for the nephron. Means you should give the main parts which are present in the nephron about that, naming only, that is the glomerulus, Bowman's capsule and the renal tubule are the main components are there of the nephron. See, also you should learn about the structure of the nephron, how it is there, sometimes asking for 3 marks, 4 marks also about the explanation of the nephron structure and function of the nephron properly. About that also may be asking about the diagram of the kidney, diagram of the nephron is also asking. And also you know about the heart diagram is there, about the explanation how there is a working of the heart is there, about that also going to ask your function and structure of the heart. Explain the structure of the heart, otherwise how there is a working of the heart is there, about that differences between arteries and veins, about that also the transportation in the plants, what the xylem vessels, xylem tracts are there, xylem fibers, xylem parenchyma are there. You should explain that one. Or types like, and about the phloem, which is a food conducting tissue, about that also you should here explain that one properly. So these are like the phloem tube with their companion cells are there. These are the phloem conducting tissues are there in that parts. So this is in the life process lesson, that parts are also very much important. About the which metal do not load easily, the metal non-metal lesson is there. In that also all the points which are nothing but the reactivity series are there, how they are reacting and how there is a refining of the metals are there, how there is extraction of the metals are there, that are also important points are there in that lesson. And about how metals are reacting with the acids and bases, about that also you should learn it properly. And diagrams which are important, you practiced already, I think you should practice properly with the labeling, draw the letter with the help of a pencil. So this is the question number second, which has 8 marks are there for that question number second. 8 questions, 1 mark each is there. So these are the two examples I gave here for the year. Answer in a one sentence. So this is about the question number 2. Thank you.